Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I'd like to thank you Start, for this opportunity, represented by Luis Guilherme and his crew. It's a huge pleasure to be here today. My name is Ivan Dick. I'm a partner of Best Advogados and a chief legal officer for digital law and tax law. And I'm here today to talk about some updates for tax and digital legal systems here in Brazil. So, and I put this figure here because legal system in Brazil looks like a mythical labyrinth. In fact, it's very, very complicated to handle with law here in Brazil. And the entrepreneur, when he starts, he's faced this labyrinth and think, whoa, what can I do? And the next, please. He simply can't imagine what he would find inside this labyrinth. So lawyers basically can help them to handle with this kind of stuff. And we, of course, that developing the model or the business plan or trying to find out how to leverage the business or to find some way to be new, it's important concerns for entrepreneurs. But if they don't think about the legal situations, the legal issues that can put the business in trouble, he won't find an investor that can hit him and put some money in their business. So, please. This is the situation in Brazil. We have a lot of bureaucracy, and we have some agencies here that need some to be in control of business, and entrepreneurs can suffer a kind of legal lawsuits, labor, consumer claims, government investigation, and with this kind of stuff on your back, in fact, there is no investor allowed to invest on you. So basically, lawyers are helpful in this situation. Yes. Normally, novice entrepreneurs can think, whoa, I don't know how to calculate my income business. What can I do with the legal issues of my company? It's easier to pay the accountant and then see what happened. But if you try to look for the other side, to contract a law firm to look for it for you, it's not a cost or a loss of time, but in fact it's an investment. An investment to be okay when the opportunity knocks your door and you have an investor interested to put some money in your business. At once I was watching a presentation about startups, and the guy that I was doing that presentation told that there are two element keys for being successful in a startup. The first one is the innovation at lower cost, which means to reduce the cost of customer acquisition. And the second one is to identification of elements that draw the attention of consumer. In example, the startup should provide an experience for that client. So lawyers can help with the first topic. The next one, please. How can lawyers help you to be different? Normally, I can tell you about two situations, corporate engineering and tax planning. This is the way that we can help you to make your agreements to be safer, to make your corporate engineer to be stronger, and to make your tax planning actually save you taxes. Everything in a lawful way. So that's how can a law firm help you to be different. Patricia Peck is a teacher of digital law here in Brazil. She told that it's government responsibility to define a strategy for public policy that stimulates digital enterprise. So it's a way to get our virtual world becoming a real world with wealth. So this kind of government responsibility is in course. It's in course. The first milestone that we have is the Micro Enterprise and Small Enterprise Act. It's the next, please. As micro enterprise, we can know about it's a company that earns a gross revenue equal to or less than 306,000 reais. And the small enterprise is that one that earns a gross revenue more than 360,000 reais, but not exceeding 3,600,000 reais. So for these companies, Brazil can provide a different tax system, which will depend of the kind of the business you're doing, can be an interesting idea, because you save tax with that. The next, please. So the incentives that Brazil offers to startups are beneficial treatment in contract with the government. It's easier to a startup to contract with government because they have this kind of incentives. Obtain specific line of credit is with public banks. Caixa Econômica Federal and Bank of Brazil can provide this kind of line of credits. And the third, agreements for calculating and collecting arrangements for calculating and collecting tax in a simple way. It's kind of simples nacional. This system put together all these taxes that we have, actually about 86 taxes to be charged here in Brazil. Of course, no company pay all of them, but can pay part of them. In this case, we have of the Simples Nacional, we have the income tax, the IPI tax, that tax for industry, the profit contribution, PIS, COFINS, and INSS. It's the taxes for social security and retirement system. Every company needs to pay that. ICMS, that kind of VAT, value aggregate taxes, and ESS, it's the tax for services. So this system put together all these taxes to be paid monthly, and with easiest way to do the account, that is very important. So this table show to you the bands of gross revenue, and it showed the number that you should pay. So how much percent do you pay for every band? You have here from 180,000 to 3,600,000 reais. This is for currency. The next one, please. If you are industry, this is your table. And for service, we have two different tables. If you want to know which one to apply, you can talk to me later. Okay. Another, please. So this is already applied to legal system in Brazil. This one that I brought is a new stuff. It's a bill in Congress. They're still talking about that, but it's really near to be approved. So the bill 321 of 2012, it's a special system for startups, and means that this is the first time in Brazilian history law that we make an appointment for startups. So now there is a legal concept of startups, that is, the legal entity that engages in provision of related service and the provision of goods such as email service, hosting and developing website and blogs, personal communication, social networks, searching engines, and advertising disclosure on the internet. Distribution of creation of original software of physical virtual media for use with computer and other electronic device. Design racks and develop other elements for their computing hardware tablet and another mobile computing device. Research activity, develop the implementation of innovation. Ideas with business model based on internet and telecommunication networks. So, the good point of it is that for this kind of startup, you don't have to pay taxes by 2 years. Good stuff that. For someone that is on the beginning of his entrepreneur life, to receive this kind of incentive, it's a very good situation. But to be eligible to these tax benefits, the startup capital shall constitute from donations of public and private or individuals or corporations, financing for public or private entities, so an international investment can be in this line, and grants for public or private entities to foster innovation and entrepreneurship. If there is any source that is not related here, there is no way to be eligible to these benefits. So, to be eligible too, the startup needs to have a quarterly gross revenue equal or less than 30,000 reais and a maximum of 4 contracted employees. As gross revenue, it's the son of God's sale the service provides and the result of operations on behalf of third parties, not including canceled sales and unconditional discounts granted. So it's not that complicated, but if you try to stay in the system without any kind of this characteristic, you'll be in trouble if you're in land. So, and this was I intend to present to you. I'm sorry, English is not my natural language, but I tried. And if you want some information, please contact me by email or Skype. Thank you very much.